right this way. Now look in the bottom right hand corner, see that green bars?
Uh-huh.
Okay, well, I think you're wrong.
Okay. Let me refresh over here on my screen. Okay, looks like we are live. Hi everyone, how you doing today? I am doing a live stream today. I thought I would do a little tour of my grow light closet. So welcome here, and hi Pam, how you doing? Nice to see you here on the live stream. It's a lot of fun just to do a kind of an impromptu one. And a lot of people have actually been asking about my grow light closet. So I thought I would do a little tour of my grow light closet and then also show my seed boxes. I was able to pretty much finish up my project that I was doing, organizing my seed boxes. So I kind of wanted to show you guys that too, and also share with you a couple of tips that I discovered as I was going along the process, and maybe that'll help you guys out too. So before we do that though, let's see, let me figure out how to get the chat on my screen. Okay. Let's see who's here. So we've got Chris. How you doing, Chris? Lauren Tell. Hi, how are you? And someone else there, I'm sorry, I can't read your name. It looks like it's in Arabic or something. I'm sorry, I can't read it. Christy, how you doing? Good to see you guys here. Ashish, Marsha from Southwest Texas. Wow, great to see you guys. And Ravi, I'm good. How are you doing? It's great to see you guys here. So what I'm doing today, for those of you that are just joining us, is I'm going to do a little tour of my grow light closet. I've had some people asking me about that. So I'm indoors today, not out in the garden. It's actually sunny today. We've had a couple of weeks of rain off and on. So I'm actually seeing the sun out my window here. Let me show you guys. I'm just here in my dining room where I've been doing some of my indoor videos. You guys can see here on my windowsill some of my microgreens. I actually just filmed a video today on wheatgrass this morning. So you can see out my window here, you can see down there, got the smart pots going on down there. But sometimes I like to work actually right here at my table because then I can see down to my garden. So that's a lot of fun. My dream is at some point in time to have a little office down there in my garden, like a little she shed kind of thing. But we'll see, hopefully at some point in the future, I think that would be a lot of fun. So wow, there's a lot of you guys joining me here today. So thank you so much for tuning in. I was hoping I would catch some people. I know it's about lunchtime here in the Southern California area, the LA area. So I was hoping I'd catch some people while they're on their lunch break. But I am going to show you where I have my grow light closet. You guys might have seen a video I did, I think it's been almost a year ago now, where I made this little closet under our stairs into a grow light closet. So if you missed that video, you want to go back and check it out. But I'm telling you guys, it's not pretty in here. It's not really that organized. It's kind of ugly. So, you know, don't be expecting anything too beautiful here. Like some people have these huge grow light rooms. Okay, that's not me. I have a little closet. All right, so let me show you what I got going on here. And then hopefully at the end of the video, I can answer, or at the end of the live stream, I can answer a few questions. Okay. All right, so here we go. Let me turn the camera around. You can see what I got going on. See, I told you we've got kind of a mess back there, but, here I have a couple of shelves that we've rigged up, and these shelves are adjustable. There's little notches back in there. I can move the shelves up and down. So I've got two of them. And on the top shelf here, well, I've got these light bulbs that are like the T12 fixtures, and the lights are compact fluorescent. I believe they're 6,500K, no, 5,000K. And 2500 lumens. So they work pretty well. I've been pretty happy with them. The only thing I wish I would have done a little bit different when I built this is there's two light bulbs in each of these fixtures, and I wish I would have got one that has three light bulbs. I don't even know if they have those, but or put attach two fixtures to the ceiling. They're attached here with just a little hook and little chains. So sometimes it's a little bit narrow of a growing space, but it does the job. It works for the space that I've got. So I'm really happy actually to have this extra space. Before, I just pretty much had my trays of seedlings all over the house. So with the little clip lights attached to them. So this gives me a little bit of space, although you can see it's kind of getting filled up. But I have a bunch of little trays of microgreens here. And some of them I'm re-sprouting after harvesting. I'll show you this here is, I think it's probably a radish, I think. And I think I've got some new little shoots coming up in there. So I'm hoping to get a couple of different crops or a couple crops out of each little tray. And let's see, way back in here, I'll just pull these down. I have the lettuce that we started last week on the growing your indoor salad greens video. So here I have one of those trays and I stuck these in here. I have one in another part of my house as well, but this is the black seeded Simpson and the Mizuna mustard. So I had these, I started these from Jiffy Peat pellets and they are growing really nice. The Mizuna mustard is actually getting kind of tall. So I think I may have to move them down to the bottom shelf later on today because I don't want them, you can see there, they're like bumping into that light. So yeah, they're definitely getting too tall for that. And then way in the back here, I'm really crawling into the closet now, guys. I've got, we started our seeds on that same video and they've already germinated. So I'm trying to remember what day I filmed that video. I think it was maybe a week ago or so. But anyway, they're already popping up and looking really good. I've been keeping them here under the light, so they should be growing nice and strong here pretty soon. So I'm really excited about that. And then down on the bottom, I've got a little basil plant. I'll show you this here. Yep, got the basil plant there going for our indoor garden series on growing herbs inside. So I've got that going in here. Did start that one from seed also. And here I have my Space Master cucumber and Chadwick cherry tomatoes that I actually shot a video on yesterday on growing these indoors. So on the video, I transplanted them and then put them under some grow lights out in my dining room. So these here are looking really good. I don't know what I'm going to do with these guys because I don't have room to grow all these inside and they're quickly outgrowing, or grow all these inside. They're quickly outgrowing my grow light closet and it's still kind of cold here in California to put a cucumber and a tomato outside. But I don't know, maybe I'll give it a try and just bring them in at night. But you can see here, they're already developing little flower buds. So I'm very hopeful that I will actually get a harvest out of these. It's pretty exciting. I've got some more tomatoes and cucumbers going on back there. So, and oh, there is one little yellow flower. So I'm going to have to figure out how to do like some pollinating indoors and all kinds of things indoors. And we'll see how it goes. It's kind of a new experiment for me, but I'm excited to try it and hoping that you guys will come along with me as well. So anyway, before I leave the grow closet, are there any questions about the grow closet that I could answer before we go out and just check out what's going on in my with my seed organizing bins? So let's see. Oh, I hear passionate gardener growing indoors too. That's great. Oh my goodness. Paul, negative 24 in Winnipeg. That's nuts. That's absolutely nuts. So Chris, Kim, if they grow tall real fast, does that mean they aren't getting enough sun? I think that's what happened to my indoor cover crop test. Yes, that does mean if they're getting leggy, these in the back here, they are just a little bit leggy. See these tomatoes? So they're kind of stretching for the light. I've also taken some of the leaves off the bottom branches here because they were getting a little bit yellow. So, you know, growing indoors is always kind of a bit of an experiment, but you definitely want to get them a couple of inches from the light. So if they're too far from the light, they will get leggy. Okay, cool. Pokemon Ranger started your seeds yesterday. That's awesome. Pam, yes, I do have seeds on there, the lights on a timer. So let me show you up here my little timer I've got plugged in there. So I run these about 18 hours a day. So they go on about 6 in the morning, go off about midnight. And that way I don't forget to turn it off or anything like that. So it just makes it a lot more convenient. Oh, and one thing I wanted to share with you guys is that I have had a lot of questions too about fungus gnats and bugs when you're growing indoors. So what I've been trying to do, I'm kind of experimenting with this and it seems to be working pretty well, is I've been keeping the fungus gnats under control with these little containers here of apple cider vinegar. So they are attracted to the smell of the apple cider vinegar and kind of the, you know, the sweetness and the apple cider vinegar. And what I do is I put a little drop of dish soap in there and that kind of just breaks the surface of the vinegar and then they fly in there and can't get out. So definitely though, fungus gnats can be a big problem indoors. you want to keep it under control before it gets out of hand. So I've been trying to do this as a preventative measure. Although I have seen some, it hasn't gotten too out of control yet. So I would recommend just doing that right off the bat as a preventative measure and avoid that problem altogether. So it really just takes a little tiny bit. Like here, I just have a little candle holder, you know, with just a little bit in the bottom. And that seems to be taking care of the problem. So if you guys have any other problem, any other questions on how you control fungus gnats, you know, let me know if you have any other ideas on how you control that, because that so far has worked pretty well for me. The cost of the whole setup, Butternut is asking that. You know what? I would have to go back and look. I filmed a video on this about a year ago. It's called... I think it's just called a grow light closet. So you can go back and check out that video. I'm not sure if I detailed out the cost in that. I think it was probably under $100 because I had to buy the shelving, bought the light fixtures and the lights, all the brackets and that kind of thing. So it was fairly inexpensive to set up. And I actually still have, I think I bought a couple too many shop light fixtures. So I could actually, if we actually got this cleaned out, I could probably add another shop light back in there and another shelf. Although camera guys wanted to use this at some point for his camera equipment. But I don't know. I think I might be growing in here year round. So, okay. So Ambient Lavina is saying that Praxis uses predatory mites to deal with fungus gnats. Okay. I'll have to look into that. So thanks for that information. Okay. So I'm going to crawl out of the grow light closet. And let's head over to my dining room table, and I'll just give you guys a little tour of my seed organizing boxes. I know a lot of you have mentioned that you've been organizing your seeds and getting ready for the spring growing season, which I'm pretty excited is actually just around the corner. So I plan to start my warm weather seeds indoors. Now, don't ask me where I'm going to put them because I still have my grow light closet full of plant starts for my indoor garden series. So I'm going to have to figure that out. Okay, Rick. Hi, Rick. How you doing? Good to see you guys. Good to see you. Did Camera Guy build this for you? I actually built it myself, believe it or not. Camera Guy definitely helped, but he was mainly on the camera at the entrance to the closet as I was filming. But he did get in there and drill some of the holes for me because, you know, I just couldn't quite, I'm not super great with a drill, but he helped me out with that as well. Okay. So, oh, look who's here, Camera Guy. He's actually working from home today, so he had to pop in there and set the record straight. Okay. All right, so now for my seed organizing boxes. So hopefully you guys were able to catch that video, but I am so thrilled with these boxes because before they were jammed into a cabinet behind me. I still haven't totally got this cabinet cleaned out, but they were jammed in there in a couple of bins, and I was able to find these boxes at Joann's, and if you guys have a Joann's Fabrics and Crafts near you, maybe you can pick some of them up too, but they were 60% off, so they ended up being, I think, around $5 a box, but they're so pretty. They're perfect for seeds because they say seed company on it, and they came in a couple different designs, but they're really gorgeous. And I organized one on the video, but then I realized I had way more seeds than I had even anticipated. So they actually ended up taking up, this one's not quite full, but they ended up taking up almost 5 boxes. So let me just open them up here. Still working on getting them looking exactly how I want it, but I think they're looking pretty good. I'm pretty happy with it. And the nice thing is, when I need to go out to the garden, I can actually find what I want fairly quickly. So basically, here's a little tour. I've got cool weather crops, and I do want to get a little label of some kind on the front here so I know what's in each box. But basically, I went back and alphabetized everything as well. I didn't mention that on the video, but of course, you know, it's going to help me find it a whole lot quicker. So I just took little cardstock pieces of paper and cut little file folders to basically fit the size of the box. And you can go back and watch the how-to video, but I'm really happy with how they turned out. They're super colorful. And what I ended up finding, I mentioned this on the video as well, some of my seeds that like I've saved myself, let me find a packet here. Okay, for example, here's a pack of marigold seeds that I've saved myself. Okay, well, it's kind of bulky. Takes up a lot of room there in the box, you can see. So I went on Amazon. I found these little Ziploc bags. And I think there's like a 2x3, 3x4 maybe, I can't remember. But they're exactly the size of in my gardener's seed packets here, which fit perfectly. So what I'm going to do is go through and switch over all my saved seeds that I've saved myself into these bags. And that way it won't take up near as much space. I mean, you can see over here, I've got like a lot of pepper seeds that I've saved. And even I think I've got some bean seeds or watermelon seeds is what takes up a ton of room. So that'll make it a much more compact. And, you know, I can fit everything in my boxes then. So, okay, I like it. It looks cool and colorful. Thank you, Dr. Trala. Yes, it really does. I love it. And I even have a little small box here. This actually still has my seeds that I'm working on filing. But my plan is to have this box be the seeds that I'm actually, you know, currently planting. Like this week, I want to plant seeds and I'll put them in here, then take this out with me to the garden. So I just think that's really pretty. So, anyways, guys, I just want to hop on here real quick and do a little lunchtime live. Hopefully you caught my Instagram live last night. I'm trying to do more live video because I really, really enjoy it. I mean, I feel like I'm just sitting down having a little chat with you guys. So, you know, make sure if you don't follow me over on Instagram to follow me over there because I'm doing a couple of live videos on Instagram a week and one or two live videos on YouTube a week. So, Chris, you need more land with all those seeds. Yeah, maybe we should like sell our house and move to a farm or something like that. I don't know. But definitely, I'm never going to get all these planted, but I just love having the variety. So anyway, guys, thank you so much for joining me today. I'm going to jump off and I look forward to seeing you guys over on Instagram, on Facebook, and then later on in comments over on YouTube. So talk to you later. Bye-bye.
Done.